bow down prostrate. You are the only one worthy of praise. Pick up the books of hadith. You know Imam al-Tirmidhi. You must have heard of the Sunan of Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah. A really famous book, Sunan of Imam al-Tirmidhi. Imam al-Tirmidhi was a student of Imam Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ismail al-Bukhari rahimahumullah wa radi anhuma. His main student from whom he took hadith. Imam al-Tirmidhi has a book, Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Actually the full name of that book is Al-Jami' al-Sunan. المختصر عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ومعرفة المعلول وما عليه العمل. That's the full name of the book. Likewise, Imam al-Bukhari's book. You know Imam al-Bukhari's book. A lot of these people say, brother, it's in Bukhari. I just ask them the actual name of Sahih al-Bukhari. الجامع المسند الصحيح المختصر من أمور رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وسننه وأيامه. Imam al-Tirmidhi رحمه الله, the great muhaddith, who has a famous book called الجامع المختصر من السنن عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ومعرفة الصحيح والمعلول وما عليه العمل. In that book, he actually talks about, it's not just a hadith book. He brings hadith and then he talks about whether a hadith is sahih, hasan, da'if, this, that, and the other. And then Imam al-Tirmidhi actually tells you as well that who has acted upon this, وَمَا عَلَيْهِ الْعَمَلِ, who's acted upon this hadith. Now when Imam al-Tirmidhi is talking about a hadith, is this hadith sahih or not, or is that a problem? He might give the reference of Imam al-Bukhari. But when it comes to fiqh, Imam al-Tirmidhi, every chapter he says, this is the opinion of such and such person, such and such person. Look at the list. The whole of Sunan al-Tirmidhi from the beginning till the end, you will never find Imam al-Tirmidhi says, oh, this opinion, whether you pray salah like this or like that, is the opinion of Imam Muslim or Tirmidhi, Muslim and Bukhari and Nasa'i and Ibn Majah. No. When he's giving references to fiqh issues, he says, this is the opinion of Malik, Shafi'i, Ahmad, Ishaq, the people of Kufa, meaning Abu Hanifa and his school. He mentions Abu Hanifa, Abdullah ibn Mubarak. He gives reference to the fuqaha, not even Imam al-Bukhari. He doesn't say, oh, this is the opinion of Imam al-Bukhari, because that's not his job. This is not his field. His field is something else. Even though Imam al-Bukhari was, even though he had a good, you know, understanding of fiqh in terms in relation to the other muhadithun, but still, Imam al-Tirmidhi, despite his own personal teacher, he says, this is the opinion, this is the hadith, this is the opinion of Imam Shafi'i, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad, Abu Hanifa, Ishaq, these are all fuqaha. So this was the job between the fuqaha and the muhadithun, that the muhadithun, they used to relate hadith and the fuqaha. And that's why the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as I said in the famous hadith, رُبَّ مُبَلَّغٍ أَوْعَى مِنْ سَامِعٍ. Sometimes the one who the hadith is transmitted to actually understands the hadith more. And this is what fiqh is, to understand, to derive. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, he says, مَن يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. The one whom Allah intends good with, the person with whom Allah intends good, يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. Allah makes him a faqih, Allah gives him a deep understanding of religion. And in the Quran, Allah says, فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِن كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفَةٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُ فِي الدِّينِ وَلِيُنذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ إِذَا رَجَعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْذَرُونَ. That there should be a group of people who should dedicate their time to fiqh, to understanding, to deriving, to extracting the laws, the rules, the injunctions from the Quran and Hadith. So fiqh really means, if someone says that this person is a faqih, means what? It means he's a mufassir and a muhaddith all in one, plus extra, he's deriving rules from the Quran and Sunnah. He has methodologies in place. It doesn't mean he's a faqih, so he doesn't know hadith. You can't be a faqih if you're not a muhaddith. Because what will you do fiqh with? You know, something else. Fiqh is only with the hadith. You can't be a faqih unless you're a muhaddith. When you say such and such person is a faqih, the meaning of that, he's already a muhaddith, now he's a faqih. Because he's received the hadith, now he's extracting rules. You can't be a faqih without hadith, because if there's no hadith, where are you going to take the fiqh out from? From some other kind of book, from the Bible? It's going to be from the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is what a faqih is. And these people, they sat down, they extracted rules. Not just Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad, all these great imams. Imam Abu Hanifa had a school set in place. He had principles, methodologies set in place, how they would derive and extract rules from the Quran and Sunnah, how they would apply the fiqh. And you know, the books have been written on this topic. They used to spend days, you know, they used to spend, Imam Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu had a committee of 40 major students. His students, Imam Abu Yusuf, Imam Muhammad ibn al-Hasan al-Shaybani, Imam Zufar, Imam Hasan ibn Ziyad, and many others, they would sit down. Sometimes 3 days, 10 days, 15 days, deliberating, discussing, debating, researching. one issue in light of the verses of the Quran and all the hadiths of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Not just one hadith you find on page 632 of Sahih al-Bukhari, for example. All the hadiths, and then sit down and look at everything, the chain of transmissions. Look at whether, you know, there's a contradiction with another hadith or not. Is there a contradiction with a particular verse of the Quran or not? And I'm just going to give you some examples how these people did that. You know, they placed principles down. They sat down principles, and this is what we call qawaid al-usuliyah. And this is something, it's quite detailed. I know a lot of people I'm just going to try to make it as easy as possible.
أرجو رضاك يا الله، أنت الرحيم يا الله.